Episode 7 of Mark Witz Radio begins now. Hello, everyone. Thanks for listening. It is Wednesday, December 14th. I can say the date because, unlike normally, I'm recording this show on the day of, which is different. Normally, I do the show late at night after a long, hard day of being a Mark Witz. And I have a cocktail in hand and talk to you lovely people. But instead, I'm in the basement with a cup of coffee. I wonder if I sound different to you. I wonder if I'm speaking faster. I bet you I'm inadvertently going to talk a lot faster because I want to get this show done and get it turned around and get it online for all of my loyal listeners. Speaking of listeners, I think I'm averaging around like 30 to 40 people on SoundCloud and YouTube between the two of them, which is pretty neat. I'm really curious who you are. I know a couple of you who reach out to me or comment who you are, but the rest of you, I don't know. I'm still curious. Is there a stranger out there who happened to latch onto this? If you have, let me know. So this week's episode is going to be about collaborations. I know last week I was trying to figure out if I was going to do covers or collaborations, and I will do a covers episode in the future. For sure. I've already got a lot of great ideas for that one. Something kind of tipped my hat to want to do the collaborations episode. I was on Reddit, good old Reddit, and there was a video getting a lot of upvotes, and it was about a blind autistic piano prodigy named Derek Paravicini. And Derek is amazing, number one. He can hear anything and know the note. He can hear the engine of a train and know the note. But if he hears a song, he can tell you all the notes, and then he can immediately replay those notes within seconds of hearing them. It's really crazy. And in the video, he collaborates with a couple different people. And I wish I had some recordings of Derek with those collaborations, but I don't. But what I do have is a really great song that I knew I needed to put in an episode of the podcast at some point. And it contains two artists that I've previously used, local natives, and then Nina Persone. Nina Persone is the lead singer of The Cardigans. And Local Natives put out a new album in 2016 called Sunlit Youth. I will admit it is not my favorite Local Natives album. The first two are very good. This is probably my least favorite album. But this track, this song, is one of my favorite songs because it took two things that I never knew I wanted to collaborate, and they have now. And the world is a better place because of it. So here we go with our first song, Local Natives, featuring Nina Persone, Dark Days.
Thank you.
How about that one? What do you think of it? I think it's really great. Some good 2016 new music. Speaking of 2016 new music, Pitchfork, the website I mentioned in my last episode, has begun releasing their top 100 tracks, their top 50 albums of the year, and boy, oh boy, do I not know any of them. I know so few of them, and there seems to be a lot of hip-hop and R&B, and that's just a genre I don't follow as much. I don't know the right artists to really draw me into the modern hip-hop and R&B, like Vince Staples, Chance the Rapper, a lot of them. I know they get a lot of positive press in like the websites and the areas on the internet that I look at, but I don't know. Pick out some songs. Tell me some things on those Pitchfork lists that I need to know about. I did pick up the new Blood Orange album, so I imagine that'll end up on a show at some point. But enough about new music, enough about me being old and not keeping up with the times, which is what it feels like. Let's play something I do know. It's old. It's 11 years old, over a decade old. It's the Chemical Brothers, and they did a collaboration with a guy named Tim Burgess. Tim is from a band called The Charlatans, and I don't know anything about The Charlatans. All I know is that I wanted to look up Tim's name, so I didn't say, I don't know anything about him, you look him up. I do that. I do that from time to time, and I'm sorry. I'm putting a lot of pressure on you. You're here to hear me talk, and I put the effort on you, and that's not right. So I looked up who Tim Burgess was this time. So here is the Chemical Brothers with Tim Burgess of The Charlatans and their song, The Boxer.
I
So I was sitting there reflecting on what I said in the last segment about not being able to follow hip-hop and R&B as much as I would like to, and I realized that I actually had more hip-hop tracks for this show, but a lot of the ones I wanted to use, I couldn't use them because of the YouTube copyright issues. I'm trying to get strict about that to make sure I check before I record a whole show and tell long stories about songs I can't even include. I don't know if you listened to last week's episode, but the version on SoundCloud and the version on YouTube are actually different because the Sigur Rós song I wanted to use, I can't use on YouTube. And I thought I could, but I spelled the name of the song wrong and did all kinds of nonsense, I mean, whatever. But yeah, I was going to put an Avalanches track in here. The Avalanches collaborated with Danny Brown and MF Doom, two rappers I do like, and I couldn't do it. Couldn't put it in. That doesn't matter, though. Let's focus on what we are going to put in this show. Let's play some hip-hop. I keep talking about it. The next one is going to be from the Virginia duo Clipse, and they worked with Pharrell, who I'm sure you're familiar with, to make this song, and I've always liked this one. It came out in 2009. I used to play this at DJ gigs pretty often when I could play hip-hop and that kind of thing, and I think it's going to be rare that there are going to be songs that I would ever play out when I DJed that are going to make it here, because that's two different worlds for me. I don't really enjoy a lot of the top 40 and things that I play at the DJ gigs, but I do enjoy getting paid, so I can't complain too much. I've definitely had far worse jobs than having to play a couple songs I don't like. I think we all have. But right now, I'm good. I'm happy. I'm good. So let's play I'm Good by Clipse featuring Pharrell.
Find me in the streets, even in the drought. My mattress is full, why shouldn't I be out? Hey buddy, I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What she tell you?
I'm good.
What you see?
$100 jeans with my favorite patch. Pulling up my ride, hell yeah, the rims match. What they tell you?
I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What she tell you?
I'm good.
What you see?
Man, I'm killing it, riding in that brand new. From selling wet weight, today is a good day. Ice cubes on my chest, looking at my BlackBerry. Freak hit me on the text. Come and beat it up, I just need a minute. You can care your ass, you ain't gotta lay in it. Yes, niggas don't like it when you're looking good. Hate it when you're shining through the neighborhood. Brand new ride, niggas know the time. Hoes cut their eyes, we call them samurais. Fly as I could ever be. A level of success that you could never see. You jealous, man. We in propellers, man. Think about it, ain't shit you could tell us, man.
In the streets, even in the drought. My mattress is full, why shouldn't I be out? Hey, buddy, I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What she tell you?
I'm good.
$100
jeans with my favorite patch. Pulling up my ride, hell yeah, my rims match. What they tell you?
I'm good.
I'm good.
What you tell you?
I'm good.
What you see?
Test it out, ma. Tell me what you see. Order what you want.
Hell yeah, it's on me.
Don't they tell you I'm good?
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What you tell you?
I'm good. What you see?
Cruising on them 22s got me sitting pretty. You should hear that engine purr. Here, kitty, kitty. Ride through the city. Everybody know me. And the sun is out. It's like it's shining on me. Shouting out the homies as I breeze by. I'm on cloud nine and I ain't even high. Told my shorty I'll be back and I ain't even lie. Them VVS's be the best that money can buy. I see you flirting, baby. Them jeans is painted on her. Mama looking right and I don't even want her. To take it personal, but that's just how it be. No disrespect to you, I'm just enjoying me. Finally I'm free, all my dues paid. Them yellow diamonds got the charm like it's mini-made. And I'm looking good, and I'm feeling good. Try and stop my shine, I wish a nigga would.
You can find me in the streets, even in the drought. My mattress is full, why shouldn't I be out? Hey buddy, I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What they tell you?
I'm good.
What she tell you?
I'm good.
What you see?
$100 jeans.
Patch.
hope you like that one. So I mentioned that last week's YouTube and SoundCloud episodes were different because of the songs I had to change. And on the YouTube version, by the way, you can see a video of me in the bathtub in that version if you have any interest. In the YouTube version, I included a spoon song to replace another song. And this next collaboration is from members of Spoon, members of Wolf Parade, members of Handsome Furs, and I think the New Bomb Turks. It's a project called The Divine Fits. Primarily, it's Britt Daniel, the lead singer from Spoon, and then Dan Bachner, I'm not sure how you say his last name, from Handsome Furs and Wolf Parade. And this one's going to sound a lot like a Spoon tune, but it's different. You can tell it's a different project. So this is The Divine Fits with Would That Not Be Nice?
I gotta know.
I don't know how many of you are familiar with China, Illinois, or the Professor Brothers. One of the brothers' name is Frank Smith. He's a character created and voiced by a guy named Brad Neely, who I really like. I'm really bummed out to hear that Brad Neely's show, Hargnall and Sklopio Peepio, yes, that's really the name of the show, isn't going to be on Adult Swim anymore. I really looked forward to it, and I got really excited when Brad Neely liked one of my tweets that I tweeted at him. So this is my best impression of Frank Smith, one of the Professor Brothers. I think it's all right, especially when I say he waved his desexing stick most unsexily. I think that's a pretty spot-on version of the voice. You can tell me if I'm wrong or not. This next collaboration is by a group, the Baldwin Brothers, another group I got introduced to when I was an undergrad at Grand Valley. And I don't remember the singer's name right now who sings on the track. I don't really want to turn away from the microphone and have to do a bunch of editing, so I'm just going to play the song and then talk about the singer when we come back.
It all turns up.
know it was kind of a stretch to do an impression of the Professor Brothers to introduce a song by the Baldwin Brothers, but I am trying to keep you people entertained, coming back, enjoying what you're listening to. The singer on that last song was a lady by the name of Angie Hart. Angie Hart is from an Australian band called Frente. So that was the collaboration, Angie Hart with the Baldwin Brothers, who hail from Chicago, Illinois. This next song, though, bro, this next song, I'm telling you, it is one of my favorites. I always say that these are my favorites, but I love this song. It's by Matthew Dear, and he brings on a collaborator, which is something he doesn't do a lot, to my knowledge. I have a lot of his music. I talk about how much I love him all the time. Matthew Dear, I'm sending you internet love vibes. Can you feel their warmth? I hope you can. So he collaborates with the lead singer of the Drums, Johnny Pierce. And you're going to notice that in most of the track, it's just Johnny Pierce singing. But when Matthew Dear comes in, with that sweet, amazing baritone voice, it puts chills down my spine every time. So here is a track by Matthew Dear featuring Johnny Pierce of the Drums. In the Middle, I Met You There.
Baby, I don't know how this will end. In the middle, the waves will keep
It is going to be tough to follow up that song because I absolutely adore it so much. Probably one of my top 10 favorite songs ever. At least top 20. I don't have either of those lists anywhere. Maybe one day I can do a show outlining my top 10 or top 20 favorite songs. Either way, like I said, I need to find a heavyweight, and I have one. David Byrne, frontman, lead singer from the Talking Heads. If you haven't heard of the Talking Heads before, I don't know what to tell you. They've been around for a very long time. I got introduced to them by my dad, and so when David Byrne started showing up in music that I liked and came to discover on my own, it was pretty interesting. And David Byrne has done a lot of collaborations. He did a really neat one with St. Vincent. Yeah, I know he's done some music with Thievery Corporation, and I almost picked that song. But then I realized I didn't really have any of the housey, dancey stuff in this episode, and it hit me. Boom, I know what I'm going to do. There's this group, Express 2, an electronic music production group that David Byrne did a track with, and I've always liked this one. So it's a great fit for the collaborations episode. So here is Express 2 featuring David Byrne on vocals with Lazy.
Thank you. friend. Imagine there's a job. Imagine there's an answer. Imagine there's a God. Imagine I'm a devil. Imagine I'm a saint. Lazy money, lazy, sexy, lazy, out of space. No tears are falling from my eyes. I'm keeping all the pain inside. Now don't you wanna live with me? I'm lazy.
Let's keep those dancing vibes going. Let's just hop right to it. The next one is going to be by Chromeo, a really cool duo. If you've never seen any of their music videos, you should look up some Chromeo music videos. You'll probably get a kick out of them. They collaborated with Toro y Moi, who I had on the last show, and this track is good. It's great. It's fantastic, worth listening to. So here is Chromeo featuring Toro y Moi with Come Alive.
For your number, I never wondered which way you would go. You woke me up from my slumber. Now let me make your work flow. Yeah. February, they won't say shit. I wish I could love you down right now on the kitchen floor. Cause we got something so real, however they feel doesn't really matter no more. So let's see you walk up out of that door. Come alive.
I hate to bother you, but would you mind moving your car real quick? I'm blocked in and I can't actually get out until you move your car. So if you could just do that. No, right now. No, right now. You're not going to? I mean, I guess I'll stick around. Whatever. It's not very thoughtful of you. I have something to admit to you. I've time traveled. It's no longer the morning. It is now the evening. I had to go finish up some loose ends on this semester of grad school. But this semester, I believe, is now behind me. I believe everything is all done. I don't have to worry about it. I get to look forward to a little bit of a break and enjoy my holidays. And now I'm back in the basement just doing the podcast for you folks. You know, I technically don't have to. Now it's the end. This whole thing started because of grad school. It was a project, part of a project, but I'm going to still do it. I think I got enough people who care, or at least are feigning that they care. They're listening just long enough to make the views go up, to make me think that they care. I don't know. Is it all a conspiracy? Is this all just some kind of head game you guys are playing with me? Quit it, okay? Quit it. And listen to this next song. It's by DeLorean. And they brought on a vocalist from the group Chairlift, Caroline Polachek. And I'm surprised that neither one of them have been on the show before. So here's the DeLorean / Caroline Polachek debut. It's Unhold.
Start it, it's right.
So in the time span of me going to take care of those errands, those items I had to address, another one of my YouTube videos got flagged for a copyright claim. And I am telling you, audience, I am telling you, faceless listeners, that I check before I put these songs on these shows now. I don't want to put this work in to have stuff shut down. I'm going to have to recut these old shows and put them back online, probably just so they can get taken down again. It's a lot of work. It's no fun. I need to take some of my positivity vibes from episode 3, which is probably going to get shut down soon enough. I need to take that positivity. I need to inject it into myself somehow, because I'm feeling defeated. Lift me up, friends. Lift me up on social media with those lovely likes and those beautiful shares. I need it. I'm an only child. Did you not know that about me? We have a problem, you know, and there was no siblings to get any of the attention, so it's all on us. It's probably the explanation for all this. Or, as I mentioned, it's a grad school project. But what if you found out that two artists you always liked used to live together when they were in college? And these two artists were so very different, or at least the personas and the music they make was so different. You could never really imagine them living together. But after you knew it, it all just adds up to how great, how awesome they are. And that's what happened with me and Peaches and Feist. Now, I've put Feist on the show previously. I haven't got to Peaches yet. But very different personas, very different types of music. Peaches is dirty and not afraid to tell you how dirty she is. Rap and hip-hop and rock and roll and screaming and all kinds of stuff. And then Feist is like, I don't know if Feist won Grammys. Has Feist won Grammys? I know she has to have won like Juno Awards or some other awards. She's such an accomplished artist. Very more on the mainstream pop side of things, at least in her songwriting styles. I find this collaboration between them after I read all this information about them living together when they were younger. And oh man, was I excited. This is off Peach's record, Rub. And I am going to give a shout out to the Grand Rapids Public Library for having an amazing collection of CDs. I missed this one when it came out, so I actually got to pick it up and listen to it from the library of all places. So if the downtown library, if you're in Grand Rapids, I'm giving them a free shout out. You should go there. They have a great collection of music. But this is Peaches featuring Feist, and the song is called I Mean Something.
No matter how old, how young, how sick, I mean something, I mean something. No matter how old, how young, how sick, I mean something, I mean something. You can push me, no stare down, plug it up, numb me, no shut down. I'm on a rampage, it's my new rage. Crisis, but I'm singing in the mid-range. What you gotta say, gotta say? What you gotta do? What you gotta say doesn't matter anymore. What you gotta do, gotta do? Then scary me, looking straight into their eyes before they bury me. Making me ends, we could be friends. Pockets inside out before you press in. What you gotta say, gotta say? What you gotta do? What you gotta say doesn't matter anymore. What you gotta do, gotta do? What you gotta say, gotta say?
So that is probably the newest to me song I've put on a podcast yet. Very excited I came across it because I like it a lot. I like what Peaches is saying. I love Leslie's lovely voice. I love it all. That one kind of has a hip-hop vibe to it, don't you think? And I was talking a bunch about hip-hop earlier in the show. As I mentioned, there was a bunch of hip-hop I wanted to put in the show but then could not. But I'm going to end it on a hip-hop track. And in the past, I've kind of ended it with songs that are a bit of a departure from the rest of the show. So this is definitely going to be that same thing. This is a track by Killer Mike off his 2012 album R.A.P. Music. It is a really good hip-hop album. One of my favorites that's come out in a long, long time. And this one is a collaboration between himself, Bun B, and T.I. In T.I., I've had to play in various forms and ways over the years when I DJ out. But I can honestly say I never really got that much into T.I. But his verse on this track really changed my opinion of him. It made me kind of look back at some of the other stuff that maybe I did like it more than I wanted to let on. So for our closing track, we've got Big Beast by Killer Mike, featuring Bun B and T.I.
Hardcore G shit, homie, all play around. Ain't shit sweet about the peach, this Atlanta clown. Home of the dealers and the strippers in the clubs, though. Catch you coming out that Magic City with a snub, ho. Lurking in the club on tourist motherfuckers. Welcome to Atlanta, up the jury, motherfucker. These monkey niggas looking for some looter in Jermaine. And all that nigga found was some Ruger and some pain. Pow, motherfucker, pow, come up off the chain. Pow, motherfucker, pow, one off in it bright. We some money hungry wolves and we down to eat the rich. Your bodyguard and shit, we strip them like a stripper bitch. These real ass killers moving silence with violence. The minute it set off, we the motherfucking wildest. I am from Atlanta that they never speak a pun. Where everybody got a sack of dope and a gun. Gun,
and you know just how it go. Playing around with that bullshit, nigga, we ain't letting shit go. When you come in, you better come correct.
I was up on the time in the projects and OG saw a young Bumby as a prospect. Thought that I would understand the streets from a very young age. So he opened up the G code to the front page. He sat me on the porch, said this where little dog sit. Pointed at the yard, said that's where big dog shit. He said don't leave till your ass get growed. And don't come back till your ass get cold. Whatever you want is whatever you can have. Bring the pain and leave them wet like they soaking in some sap. When you step out on the app, make sure they wanna see ya. Cause being drilled is an automata. Be about it like a G. I hate I wanna get you slipping. Drop to be a Jordan, but settle for a Pippin. Player, I ain't even tripping. But I don't really care, cause my pistol's in your face. So put your hands in the air.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm riding with a pistol grip, banana clip from Simpson Road to Adamville. I'm reppin' this Atlanta shit. A nigga try and handle up, let's see can they handle this. 100 rounds at them, that ain't no Louisiana shit. Drinking on that Hennessy, blowing on that cannabis. America, cause nightmare, trap nigga fantasy. A record full of felonies, searching for a better me. But choppers go off in my hood like I wreck you with Tel Aviv. Shoot a nigga, let him bleed. Fuck a shout, suck a nigga, I'd never be, don't give a fuck about it. Quick to run up on that out and make him get the fuck about it. Nigga better be about it, he deserve it, he allow it. What's a coward to a kamikaze? He ain't robbing, man, he predator and prey. The law of nature where I stay. I catch you slipping with that K, ain't no illusion and no confusion. Better come up off that cake and all that jewelry or you're
screwed.
Yeah,
yeah. And you know just how it goes. Playing around with that bullshit, nigga, we letting shit go. When you come in, you better come correct. It's real shit, you gotta show respect.
What are they? What are da da dang? Listen to my Timber 45 go bang. Bang, bang, grind time, rap gang. We the readers of the books and the leaders of the crooks. Predators, we eyeballing all of y'all lanes. Let me fall off, I'm taking all of y'all chains. All of y'all watches and all of y'all cars. Well, who we talking to? All of y'all stars. Y'all rappers and producers and such. No homo promo, homie, you might get your ass punched. Like Def Jam, circa 83, you get rushed. If you rollin' with some winners, then you rollin' with us. I know some dumb country niggas, but them niggas ain't weak. Know they dress and look the part, but them niggas ain't cheap. I don't make dance music, this is R.A.P. Opposite all that sucker shit, they
they play on TV.
And you know just how it go. We ain't playing around with that bullshit, nigga. We ain't letting shit go. When you come here, you better come correct. It's real G shit, you gotta show respect.
I went to Atlanta for my senior year high school spring break. My cousin lived down there. I didn't really make any plans for myself. My mom kind of suggested, well, you should do something. So I did. I went and saw my cousin Kim down in Atlanta and hung out with her roommates and had a nice time. I don't remember seeing Luda or Jermaine, and I don't remember getting involved with any of the activities that Killer Mike or Bun B or T.I. or Trouble, who's also on that song, I don't remember getting into any of the activities they described. But I did just take some time and listen to that song and sip on some Hennessy myself, celebrate the end of my grad school semester. I posted a video online. You can go check it out of what it looks like when I'm sitting by myself in my basement sipping on a cocktail, or in this case, sipping out the bottle of Hennessy, going crazy on this Wednesday night, or technically I believe it is now Thursday morning, but it's midnight. It's not really, though. I don't like calling it the morning. It's still Wednesday night to me. That's the show, though. I'm kind of going off on tangents there. The end of the show, we're there. And that was collaborations. I hope you liked it. Speaking of collaborations, next week should be an actual collaboration with me and my good friend, dear friend, my fraternity big brother, my ex-roommate, and just an all-around swell gentleman, James, should be joining me on the show. It'll be a collaborative show, and we're going to do a special holiday episodes. I think it's going to be a lot of fun, and I can't wait to do it, but it's the end. I'd like to thank you so much for sticking around to the end. I hope you enjoyed this collaborations episode, and thanks for tuning in to Mark Witz Radio. Well, last week I mentioned that the SoundCloud and YouTube version.